everybody, Morrow here, and today I've got a reaction for you guys. I'll be reacting to two disturbing true Pokemon Go stories. Now, when I get home to my mom's and ask her for her phone, I will play Pokemon Go. Pinky promise. I always make promises. Well, I'll just roll the footage. Roll the footage.
This happened a few nights ago, when I was hanging out with my friend, Simon. We both used to be big fans of the Pokemon series when we were much younger. In fact, it's over Pokemon that the two of us first bonded all those years ago, back when Red and Blue were released on the Game Boy. We collected the cards, got together to watch the anime, and played Pokemon Stadium on the N64 for hours on end. Simpler times. So, despite now being in our 20s, when Pokemon Go went live the other day, we were both quick to download it. We hadn't really kept up with the series since we were kids, but since the game was focused on the original lineup of Pokemon, it seemed like a fun way to try and recapture some of that childhood innocence, and indulge in a thick slice of nostalgia pie. After playing around individually, we decided go on a late night Pokemon hunt together. We both had work the next morning, but neither of us are party people. We both had co-workers who'd sometimes come into the office hungover and running on barely any sleep, so this could be our much more nerdy version of that. Talk about walking on the wild side, right? It also made it seem a bit more like an adult activity as well. Not that we had anything to prove to anyone, but still. It's around 2:30 a.m. and we're driving through the empty streets of our hometown, getting out occasionally and scooping up as many of the little pocket monsters as possible and gaining plenty of sweet, sweet XP. We've been out on our hunt for around an hour, and honestly, the game wasn't what I was hoping it would be. But we were both still having fun in the spirit of things, so at least I'd get a couple of nights entertainment out of this game. It was around this time that we both noticed the same thing. The lure module had been activated at a nearby Pokestop. For those of you who don't know, when you use a lure in the game, it attracts a bunch of Pokemon to the surrounding area, usually more uncommon ones that you wouldn't typically find in your area otherwise. It also tends to attract other players as well, since everybody benefits from the lure, not just whoever uses it. They can only be used at Pokestops, which are usually places of interest, like monuments or landmarks. The Pokestop where this one had been used was in a park nearby. This meant that somebody else was out hunting for Pokemon at 2:30 in the morning. Okay, well, we'll be the judge. We were doing the same thing. But why at the park? When they could have just as easily activated it at one of the many other Pokestops in town. That's the one that seems strictly just to us. And we can do something to it. It's not like we've been playing the game long. We both sort of convinced each other to go down and deal with it. A mini adventure in our otherwise very ordinary lives. We arrive and park our car in the tiny parking lot. We stay back for a moment, scanning the park. And though it's a decent size and not amazingly well lit, it seemed at first glance to be completely empty. Figuring that whoever dropped the lure had probably gone home already, we step out of the vehicle. We hang around for 5 minutes or so, and Simon heads off out of eyeshot to catch something. I'm still standing close to the car, too preoccupied with my phone to see where Simon's wandering off to. From behind, the headlights of a car illuminate. I turn to see that someone's parking up in the lot close to Simon Pullman's car. second of parking up, the driver's side door opens. Hey, kid. Kid, what the hell? You're playing Pokemon Go? Not a question, a statement. My eyes adjust, and it's this lone guard, sort of half standing out of the driver's side door. From what I could tell, he had to be in his fitness, and definitely looked a little rough around the edges. Yeah, I replied. Find any Pokemon yet? Everything about this dude was a little off. His twitchy mannerisms, his eyes that kept darting around. I know some good spots I can show you nearby. Pop in, we can hunt them together. Thanks, man. I'm hunting them with my buddy over there. That didn't seem to register with him. Come on, you can ride shotgun. I'm getting bored playing by myself. My buddy and I are just heading off home. Thanks, but no thanks. I felt completely exposed, standing in the bar, with this guy's lights shining right on me. Get in there. There's a great spot not far from here. He tried to convince me multiple times before Simon, who had heard what was going on, made it back. This old dude's face visibly dropped at the sight of Simon. Must have thought I was lying about not being alone. We quickly got to Simon's car. This guy's eyes fixed on us the whole time. Had that been the end of it, this would have just been a freaky, uncomfortable experience. We jumped into the car, acting cool on the surface, silently regretting that we were stupid enough to come here. Simon turned on his headlights and started to reverse. As the headlights hit the guy's car opposite us, we both saw something that young love could. A hooded figure rising up from the back seat of the car, behind the passenger side seat. He fucking hightailed it out of the parking lot and back into the well-lit streets. They followed close behind us for a few minutes, forcing us to take the long route back to my place so they couldn't find out where I lived. They eventually gave up on their intimidation tactic and left us alone. We're not sure what this was all about. They clearly dropped the lure to attract people. If they wanted to rob us, they could have easily, but they didn't. We were hoping someone would turn up alone. Maybe someone younger, despite how late it was. What they were planning on doing if I got in that car, I have no idea. But the fact that the guy said he was alone, and even the man was making a conscious effort to hide, leads me to believe there was something sinister. We informed the cops about the incident, but I'm not sure how seriously they took us, or even if they fully understood what we were talking about. We gave them the license plate number, and they said they'd look into it. Haven't heard anything from them so far. If you decide to go out hunting for Pokemon in secluded areas, make sure to bring someone with you, especially at night. Just go at a reasonable time. Had I not taken Simon along with me, I'm not sure things would have ended as innocuously as they did.
Yeah, anyway guys, hope you enjoyed the video because my camera can't record for 15 minutes. I'll see you all in the next video. Peace.